Pi DataLink has been and continues to be one of OSIsoft's most used client tools. Over the past two decades, OSIsoft technical support has answered well over 100,000 calls concerning Pi DataLink. As you might expect, we have created documentation along the way to help us efficiently answer these calls, and also to try to deflect some questions outright, as customers can find what they need on our customer portal without our assistance. This section will give you an overview of the most used articles for Pi DataLink so that the next time you have a question about Pi DataLink that the user guide doesn't answer, you will know how to use the same resources that we use. Speaking of documentation, let's start off this section by seeing how you can find Pi DataLink's documentation. You can get to the HTML help file by selecting any formula and hitting the question mark button. This help file contains a lot of information on how to use DataLink and its functions. It also has a function reference that goes in depth on each function. Let's look at the help file for compare events. Now let's take a look at the articles on the customer portal. You can use the search bar at the top to search for your articles. Let's look at the DataLink playbook that we mentioned earlier. As I mentioned before, this will give an overview of DataLink's data flow, and I'll also include some useful articles for troubleshooting DataLink. One of the most common errors with DataLink is that the ribbon doesn't appear. Let's take a look at that article. We can also search for the article directly. Let's search for Pi DataLink ribbon. And as you can see, we return the same result. What if we forget how to use AF get trace? Let's try searching for that. When you search, you can filter by content type, so we can filter for only articles, for known issues, for product feedback, etc. Let's click on the AF Get Trace article. And this article will link us to the documentation. So hopefully next time you're using or troubleshooting DataLink, you'll know that you have access to the documentation and a lot of the articles that technical support uses to solve issues. Of course, if you run into something that doesn't have an article associated, or if you have any questions, you can always feel free to call us.